Hey everybody, welcome to our chat. If you own or operate a restaurant in downtown Easton, Pennsylvania, this video is for you. I'm gonna look at the landscape, the numbers, all this stuff, and tell you how the best to succeed, because it's gonna be very challenging and it's already very competitive. There are almost 50 restaurants in the downtown, isn't that something? And there's gonna be even more, because I think they're putting a restaurant in the Marquee and in the Confluence, because every developed building has to have a restaurant in it, of course. And the downtown is not that big. It's only a half a mile by a third of a mile. There are about 1,000 metered parking spots in the downtown, and there's almost 1,000 parking spots in the two parking garages that are downtown. It's a lot of spots. However, there's 2,300 people approximately that live downtown. So even half of that, if there's, 1,000 cars. Now, they're not all home at the same time, but that's cars that have to be either parked on the street if they have the parking permit, or they pay to park in one of the parking garages. So that, on any given time, that's a lot of spots. Now, you add a state theater show or a pub crawl or some kind of event, and these parking garages are almost maxed out, which means even less parking spots. Now, if you've got 50 restaurants trying to get people in the door and fill the seats, and there's a finite shrinking amount of parking spots, that's a problem, because it's only gonna get worse. I'm not trying to be a naysayer, I'm just calling it like it is, because when the apartments at the National are done, those people are gonna be parking in the parking garage behind the public market, have permit for that. When the hotel is done, they got a parking variance, so they're gonna be parking in the parking garage behind City Hall. When the Confluence is done, they got a parking variance, and there was an article a few months ago that they said, well, they'll let them park in the parking, the residents that live there park in the parking garage behind City Hall. So these spots are evaporating. So in order to have a successful restaurant, you gotta do a lot more than just have the food be good. You know, it's hard enough, as you know, to run a restaurant. But I've got some ideas and some thoughts to share with you about making it work and really thriving in the downtown, because it is possible. The first suggestion is be open on Monday. We're here at lunch, we're like, where do we go? So many places are closed on Monday for lunch and dinner. Be open on Monday. Steak Cafe is open on Monday. They're jamming, they're rocking and rolling on Mondays. Great day to make more money on a Monday. Plus there's less people down here, so there's more parking. Make lunch work. A lot of my clients, I can't do it, the staffing and stuff, and after COVID, it dropped off. Make lunch work. Even if it's just, let's say, Friday, when people like to go out to lunch, because you can't survive on dinner on the weekends alone. So if you make lunch work, there's less people down here, there's more parking spots, do something different, have some kind of great deal, do a buffet, but make lunch work. You can do it. And you might have to get creative to make it work. I get it, you gotta pay for staff, and you gotta pay all this extra stuff. But there's an opportunity there. Also, get that catering business going. I mean, some of my restaurants clients, the catering carries the business. So if you're not focused on that, get focused on it. Get it on your site, get it out there on social, get some catering gigs, join the Chamber of Commerce, try and get some catering gigs that way. But catering, it's kind of more open and shut. You can make it easy, you can do party trays, but do some sort of catering, because they don't have to drive here and park to get it. You can take it to them. There's plenty of offices around, parties, events. People need catering. That's not going away. So if you have catering, build up on that. If you don't offer it, get a game plan together. Incentivize your manager, your employees to do this. Have some fun with it. Do something different. That's a success. Also, come up with a grab and go option if it makes sense for your place for lunch. Something simple. Get them in the door. Also, focus on your customers in your backyard, the people that live downtown, because they already have to park their car somewhere and they can walk to your establishment. You know, give them a discount if they live downtown, or, you know, Bar Torino just opened at the Seville. Say, hey, if you're a Seville resident, you get 5% off, or you get something, because these people are here. They live here. So and then they have people visiting, they want to go out to eat. Cater to them, because they could get to your establishment, and cater to the people that work down here again with lunch or options for after work, because they're already here. They don't have to make a point to come here and find a place to park or camp park and turn around. Now, some other things are focus on delivery. Now, I know that these services take a big cut, maybe hire your own driver, wrap the car, do something, but focus on delivery. You got people all around you. You got the kids at Lafayette on College Hill. You got Southside, you got Phillipsburg and beyond. Focus on delivery. Yes, it's added expenses and logistics and stuff, but hey, if people want your food and they just say, I'm not driving down there, give them the option and get that in their face that you deliver. Now, again, it doesn't work for everybody, but if you can, do it. You also have to innovate or do something different. Like, for example, Time, which opened at the top of the Commodore, they've got the view. That's their thing, and people are gonna go there for that, and they'll be happy to wait or whatever. They got that. You got Oak, which has the rooftop deck thing with the roof opens. That's cool. You need to innovate and have something different, not just good food, that people want to go there. Also, stop doing your own social. Hire us or an ad agency to do your social media for what it costs. It pays for itself. And again, we've talked about this in other videos I've done where it just looks so lousy, how you put so much thought into your food and your decor and all this, and you have some video with the shadow of the phone in it, or you're posting a picture of the menu you printed that's unreadable on social. It is so worth it. It doesn't have to cost a lot, just slow and steady wins the race, but hire an agency to do your social. You'll thank me later. Also, have a real ad plan, because just posting on social is not gonna move the needle. I see these restaurants, some of them struggling, they're posting on social all the time. You need to do more than that. Have a real ad plan, paid advertising, that type of thing. Something we've done, and again, marketing to the people in your backyard, we have the addresses for all the apartment buildings downtown. So we do a mailing for our clients just to them. Laser targeted, it's your customer base, they don't have to drive to get there, they're in your backyard, it pays for itself. So get an ad plan together, mix of traditional, digital, that type of thing, and be plan it out and be consistent. Again, slow and steady wins the race. You do not have to spend a lot of money. So those are just some ideas to think about. Every restaurant's different, and you're gonna have to look at your pain points and your strengths, do a SWOT analysis, and see what can we do to rise above this problem that is here already, because we've got these people saying, oh, I don't wanna drive down there anymore. And it's only gonna get worse. Again, not trying to be a naysayer. Plus, you throw the construction on that. Roads closed, these different things, parking spaces taken up. You know, it's gonna affect things. All these things matter. So plan now. If you want, get a free consultation with me. We'll look at what we can do because it's possible. But doing the same thing is not gonna work. And just hoping people come in the door because your food is good is not gonna work, because you have all these new places opening. People are curious about those, and then they make new habits, and you might not be on the rotation anymore. So competition is good. It's good for everybody. An opportunity to up your game makes the offerings to the consumer better. So it's doable, but you gotta be realistic about it. So hit me up. We'd love to talk to you about this. We love working with restaurants and food producers. We can help you get through this and do really well and come out on top.